97.
I believe, therefore, that it is my duty to bring your attention to the following facts and recommendations.
Where are my prisoners?
Dolphin Jerk, you're not getting more, sir.
Why are you here again?
Sir, we brought you to your prisoner!
The banker.
Yes!
Let me see him.
This Jew, this awful Jew, is on trial for assaulting an officer.
He lied! He did it! No, he lied! Ah!
Any last words?
You're gonna have to answer to God for this.
Hello? Yeah? He's out right now. Alright, yeah, here he is.
Hello?
Turkey.
Mom?
How many times is this?
Off,
like,
your,
six
yeah, I turned off the stove. Yeah, I'm sure. Oh yeah, well, you're a disappointment to me too. Hello? Yeah. I'm sorry. Y'all come home at 8. Yeah, pick up your medicine. Okay. Love you. Bye. Mothers. Ma! You can't! Oh, sorry, Chief. Tell him I'm sorry.
Hey, he's sorry. Yeah, Chief. I got murder. I'll transfer you over.
Hello? Murder? Alright, can I have the name? Alright, age? Location? Quarter mile? Sharp shopper. Alright, we'll send somebody right over. Alright, bye. Well, guys, murder on our hands.
So is he okay?
Pablo, he's dead. He's not gonna come back. He's dead.
He could be fine.
So, anyway, name, Paco Rodriguez, age 16 to 17. Body's located a fourth of a mile past a Sharp Shopper in Knox.
Mm-hmm.
So,
my wife goes shopping there quite often.
I heard they got pretty good prices.
Nah, they rip you off.
Okay. Anyway, we should probably get down there.
Alright, let's do this.
Hey, we're going to Dunkin' Donuts?
Why not?
Okay, Tony's buying.
Woo! No, I'm not.
Schweitzer.
Yeah.
Then I can get the weekend off.
Why?
Kid's having a birthday.
Well, we're really busy right now, so.
Ah.
Hey, over there.
I said over there.
Yes.
Oh, put it there.
Nice Honda the guy has.
Yeah.
I got my rack. Alright, look around, Zach. There's some evidence. Hey, look for any traces of murder.
Examine the body. I'll look for some evidence.
Uh-huh.
Oh!
What?
Found some hair!
Pick it up.
What?
Hey, Schweitzer.
Yeah.
Hey.
What'd you find?
I want to take a look at this. It's our murder weapon. Suspect must have threw it in here and tried to hide it. I'll secure the weapon. See if we can find some shells.
On it. Hey, Dale, come here.
break the rail. Would have had to been in pretty close range.
Call the morgue. Get him out of here.
Yeah, alrighty. We got a body that needs to be picked up. Alright, bye. Said half an hour and we'll be here.
Alright.
Cool. Alrighty. Got some hair samples. I guess take these back to the lab with the gun. Get them analyzed.
Let's do it.
Alrighty. Hello, sir. Would you like a kid in the can?
I sure would. What is it? How do I get one?
Well, it's simple. It's a kid plus a can, which would equal a kid in the can.
I'll take one.
Awesome. Try kid in the can. You can also order our kid in the cans up at kidinthecan.com, or you can call us at 1-800-KIDINTHEBOX.com.
But wait! There's more! If you call right now, you can get deluxe KidnaCan. 2-in-1. You could possibly be twins. I have no idea. I don't package these things. I don't even know if I'm a person anymore.
Come in. Hey, did you find the prints?
Yeah.
Good. Found some hair.
All right. I'll start there for you.
Okay, good luck.
Yeah.
All right. Looks like we know who these are from.
I wonder if old Pablo's got that forensics for us.
I don't know. I hope so.
Yeah, me too. Come on. Get that. Hey.
I found out who our murderer is. It's Jason Johnson.
Okay. Guess we can review some personal files on this guy and
yeah, let's just go get the guy. Come on.
Let's go. Don't want you for the weekend. Don't want you for a night. I'm only interested if I can have you for life. Yeah. I know I sound serious. Baby, I am. You're a fine piece of real estate and I'm gonna get me some land.
Yes.
And so it is.
Where were you May 4th at 2 in the afternoon?
That was a Saturday.
I was in La La Land. Somebody bring me the file on this dude.
Thanks. I have a question for the guy. If you were in La La Land, then why was your DNA found on the murder weapon?
The Hollow Land is a very magical place, sir. Ow.
Okay, Mr. Johnson, let's see. Ain't looking good for you, buddy. We have your fingerprints on the murder weapon. Your hair was found at the crime
scene. Yeah. What's the damage?
The damage is possible life in prison without parole.
I always don't have to pay anything. Stupid government.
Okay. Do you recognize this man?
Never seen him in my entire life.
I find that hard to believe.
Well, you never believed in imagination, haven't you?
Considering you're the man who murdered him.
What are you talking about, you crazy person?
We know you did it. Just admit to doing it, and we'll see about striking a deal.
How about no?
Okay. Playing hardball, huh?
I play baseball. Yeah.
Thank you, Batman. Now, there's two ways we can do this. We can drag you out of here and beat you until you confess, or you can just confess now and save us all a lot of trouble.
How about option three, where you give me $100 and I go out of here on my Ferrari?
No.
Well, that's the only chance I'm gonna take.
That's it. Come on.
Oh, God. Where are you taking me?
Come on.
Oh, you're gonna beat me up, aren't you, with your girly arms?
Come on.
You don't have the guts to beat the crap out of me.
You ready to confess now, boy?
I guess you do have the guts, but I'm still not confessing. Yeah.
We know you did it. We have your weapon, and we have like four witnesses that say they saw you.
You still can't prove it.
Yes, we can. Our forensic scientist here will explain to you why, aka Batman.
Well, I sampled your DNA and your hair, and it traced right back.
Blah, 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 science talk. That's all I want.
Shut up.
Now you can either confess and walk out of here with...
Die before I confess.
We can make that happen.
Well, I bet you can't.
Yes, you can. Do you want to take the chance on that?
I sure as hell would.
This guy ain't talking.
Chief!
Yeah?
He's all yours.
Talk. You did it. Confess. How about no?
Look, we can do this all day.
I'm sure we can.
I got nowhere to be.
I bet you don't.
Talk.
Come here, hold on.
Look, we can do this all day. Confess.
I don't care what you say, I'm still not confessing.
Confess.
I was trained by the army not
to
confess.
Look, I'll give you one more chance. Confess.
Confess!
We got another call witnessing you at the murder.
So that's five, isn't it?
Yes. That's five people with perfectly clean backgrounds that had saw you there.
Now I'm bored anyways. Go ahead, take me. I don't give a crap.
Did you commit the murder?
Sure, why the heck not? I don't know.
I'm going to get the lawyer up here.
10 minutes.
She's crazy. She is.
I'll get it.
Jesus.
Man.
Tony is crazy. My life.
All right, I better go calm that woman down.
You better. She's
go.
Pretty crazy, man.
I know.
I thought she was gonna hit me with that. You know what I think she was aiming for? Me.
Have a seat, man.
Do you have some water, please?
You can call her.
I need to calm down.
Alright.
I think you owe him an apology.
I'll get to him later. Right now, we have to get down to business. Okay, officer?
Alright, my name's Officer McLean.
You know who I am.
Yes, I do. Alright, where were you at the time of the murder?
get a breather. I was mowing my yard.
Okay. What time was that, man?
Let me guess or think. Oh, I want to say roughly around 2:30, 3 o'clock.
All right. Where was your son?
He was at a friend's house.
All right. When did you... Why did we find your son's prints on the gun board?
I have no idea. We had no weapons. I couldn't even begin to tell you. If it is his prints, well, why is it on the gun? We don't have no weapon. I don't know.
Is your son a passive violence?
Yes, he does. He has a medical condition that needs medication to control his behavior.
What's the problem?
The problem with his behavior, yeah, or with what he's being accused of?
What's his being accused of?
Could you elaborate on
that? Well, I heard past that the neighbor's been had some problems with neighbors.
Yes. We have no trespassing signs up on our property. And they keep coming over, not paying attention to the signs. And Jason would just go nuts. Yell on wise. No physical contact, nothing. He would just be very vocal about his displeasure.
Okay. How long has this been going on?
We've been in the house 3 years. So I want to say maybe 2.5 years.
Do you own any weapons?
I personally don't, and that I'm aware of, there's none in our house.
Have any weapons been involved in these reactions with your son and neighbors?
Maybe a few times, but it was our neighbors who had the weapons, not Jason.
Kind of evidence or weapons?
Let me think. I've seen a rifle, and there was some knives.
When shall we three meet again, in thunder, lightning, or rain?
When the hurly-burly's done, when the battle's lost and won.
That will be the air, the set of sun.
Where the place?
Upon the heath.
There to meet with Macbeth.
I come, Grey Malkin.
Paddock calls.
And on.
Fair is foul, and foul is fair. Hover through the fog and filthy air.
Blooded man is that? He can report at Seamoth by his plight of the revolt, the new estate.
This is the sergeant who, like a good and hearty soldier, fought against my captivity. Hail, brave friend. Say to the king the knowledge of the broil as thou didst leave it.
Doubtful it stood, as two spent swimmers that do cling together and choke their art. The merciless MacDonald, worthy to be a rebel for that the multiple villainies of nature do swarm upon him. From the western isles of Kearns and Gallowglass is supplied, and fortune, like Valier's minion, curved out his passage till he faced the slaves which never shook hands nor blade farewell to him, till he unseen him from the nave to the chops and fixed his head upon our battlements.
A valiant cousin, worthy gentleman.
As once the sun gained his his reflection. Shipwrecks, storms, and direful thunder break. So from that spring one's comfort seemed to come discomfort swells. Mark, King of Scotland, Mark, no sooner justice had the Bever arm compelled these skipping kerns to their to trust their heels. But the Norwegian lord surveys vantage with foolish arms and new supplies of men bring a fresh assault.
Dismayed not this, our captain's Macbeth of Banquo.
Yes, a sparrow is eagled, or the hare is a lion. If I say so, if I must report, they were as cannons overcharged with double crack, so they doubly redoubled strokes upon the fell. Except they went into battle and reaped wounds and mesmerized another Gogolosh. I cannot tell, but I am faint. My gashes cry for help.
So why thee as thy wounds? They smack the honor both. Go get him, surgeons.
The worthy Thane of Ross.
What hath lost, noble Macbeth hath won. Is execution done on Cawdor? Are not those in commission yet returned?
My liege, they are not yet come back, but I have spoke with one that saw him die, who did report that very frankly he confessed his treasons, implored your highness's pardon, and set forth a deep repentance. Nothing in his life became him like the leaving it. He died as one that had been studied in his death to throw away the dearest thing he owed, as 'twere a careless trifle.
Give me my sword. Who's there?
A friend.
What, sir? Not yet at rest. The king's abed. He hath been in unusual pleasure, and sent forth great largess to your offices. This diamond, he greets your wife withal, by the name of most kind hosts, and shut up in measureless content.
Being unprepared, our will became the servant to defect, which else should free have wrought.
All's well. I dreamt last night of the three weird sisters. To you, they have showed some truth.
I think not of them, yet when we can entreat an hour to serve, we would spend it in some words upon that business, if you would grant the time.
At your kindest leisure.
If you shall cleave to my consent, when 'tis, it shall make honor for you.
So I lose none in seeking to argument it, but still keep my bosom franchised and allegiance clear. I shall be consulted.
Good repose the while.
Thanks, sir. The like to you.
Go bid the mistress. My drink is ready. She strike upon the bell. Get thee to bed.
Worthy master stirring? Ah, our knocking has awakened him. Here he comes.
Good morrow, noble sir.
Good morrow, both. Is the king stirring, worthy thane?
Not yet.
He did command me to call timely on him, and I have slipped the hour.
I'll bring it to him.
I know this is a joyful trouble to you, yet 'tis one.
The labor we delight in physics pain. This is the word.
I'll make so bold to call, for 'tis my limited service.
Goes the king hence today?
He does, he did appoint so.
Oh, horror, horror! Tongue nor heart cannot conceive nor name thee!
What's the matter?
Confusion now hath made his masterpiece, but sacrilegious murder hath broke upon the Lord's anointed temple, and stole hence the life of this building.
What is to say? The life? You mean your majesty?
Approach the chamber and destroy your sight with a gorgon. Do not bid me speak. See, then speak yourself. Away! Away! Ring the alarm bell! Murder! Treason! Banquo! Dolomain! Malcolm! Away! Shake off this drowsy sleep, death's counterfeit, and look on death itself! Up, up, and see the great doom's image! Malcolm! Banquo! As from your grave, rise up! Walk like spirits to the countenance of this horror! Ring the bell!
80 I can remember well. Within the volume of time I have seen hours dreadful and things strange, but this sore night hath trifled former knowings.
Good father, thus it sets the heavens as troubled with man, Zach, threatens his bloody stage. By 'tis clock, 'tis day, and yet dark night strangled traveling lane. Its night's predominance for the day's shame, the darkness does the face of earth entomb, when living light should kiss it.
'Tis unnatural, even like the deed that's done on Tuesday last. A falcon towering in her pride of place was by a mousing owl hawked at and killed.
And Duncan's horses, the thing must most strange and certain, beautiful and swift, the minions of their grace, turned wild in nature, broke their skulls, flung out, contending against obedience, as they would make war with mankind.
'Tis said they eat each other.
They did so. The amazement of my eyes that looked upon him. Here comes the good Macduff. How good the world, sir?
Why see you not?
Is known who did this more than bloody deed?
Those that Macbeth has slain.
The lies the day, what good could they pretend?
They were subordinates, Malcolm and Donalbain, the king's two sons. They are fled. Now suspicion falls on them for the deed.
Against nature still, thriftless, invention that will rave up sight. Own life means that his most like the sovereignty will fall upon the death.
He is already named, and gone to scones to be invited.
Where is Duncan's body?
Carried to Colkill. The sacred storehouse of his predecessors and the guardians of their bounds.
Will you go to Scone?
No, cousin, I'll go to Fife.
Why will, thither?
Well, may you see things well done there. Adieu, lest our robes sit easier than our new.
Farewell, father.
God Benson go with you. And those that would make good of bad and friends of folks.
Oh my god.
I liked it.